Hey, it's ShadowACS again. If Naruto is the quintessential ninja anime, and One Piece is the quintessential pirate anime, and Ghost in the Shell is the quintessential cyborg anime, I guess you could say Akame ga Kill is probably the quintessential assassin anime. While it's definitely more recent than those other shows, having only come out just a couple years ago, its popularity has spread enough that I think it definitely deserves that title. So let's take a look at it. This is Akame ga Kill. You know, it always kind of annoys me when the official English translations of anime titles are only half-translated. Akame Kills. There, that's a perfectly good title, why didn't they just use that? Anyway, Akame ga Kill is a recent hit that, from what I've heard, has had fans of the manga kind of pissed off, but everyone else seems to really enjoy it. And for my part, I thought it was a pretty damn awesome show. This was another one where I knew very little about it going into it except for the basic premise. A bunch of revolutionary assassins take on a corrupt government in a fantasy world. And if you know that premise, it pretty much gives you exactly what you think you're going to see. A team of colorful characters, some really good action, fighting bad guys, all that good stuff. But with that said, I was surprised at how much the show had a real dramatic and emotional edge to it. In fact, it's downright depressing at times. But I mean that in a very good way, where you feel the emotional impact of what happens but still want to keep watching. I remember when I first sat down to watch Magi the Labyrinth of Magic, which a lot of people still bash me for not liking, this was the kind of show I wanted to see. Something that not only introduced a bunch of colorful characters in a fantasy world, but made me care about those characters. Anyway, let's take a look at it. Our main character is a boy named Tatsumi, a young warrior from a poor backwoods village on the outskirts of a powerful empire. The story begins with Tatsumi journeying to the Imperial Capital to try and use his skills as a fighter to make some money for his village. But he quickly discovers that the Imperial Capital is basically a giant hellhole in sheep's clothing. Corruption is spread on a regular basis, citizens are being exploited for money and labor, horrible crimes among the upper classes go unpunished, it's just a mess. Shortly after arriving, Tatsumi falls into a trap, only to have his life saved by a group of assassins known as Night Raid, who, after witnessing Tatsumi's skills as a fighter, allow him to join them. Their group has one purpose, make life hell for the Empire by killing as many corrupt officials as possible, weakening the capital enough that a revolutionary uprising can eventually overthrow the current regime. The story follows the missions Tatsumi goes on as a member of Night Raid all the while leading up to the revolution. The members of Night Raid include an ex-imperial assassin named Akame, a party girl named Leone who can turn into a half-beast, a former soldier named Bulat, a girl named Mine who's a classic anime tsundere, a woman named Shell, a womanizer named Lubbock, and their tough commander Najida. There's a lot of good things to talk about with this cast. Akame, for example, is a great character. I've always had a thing for characters who are very quiet and have a dark past, but convey so much through what they don't say rather than what they do. I think even just the look in her eyes when she and Tatsumi first meet says so much about what kind of person she is and what she's had to go through. That takes some really great writing and animation to pull off. And it works! From the beginning, I wanted to know more about her, and I loved it whenever she was on screen. And impressively enough, they also managed to get a few really good comedic moments in with her. One of the few common anime gags that I actually really enjoy is when a character who's usually very quiet and withdrawn shows a really funny over-the-top side to them. In Akame's case, it's that she's obsessed with eating huge amounts of food. And she always keeps the same calm, unfazed expression while she's stuffing her face. It's both really funny and bizarrely really cute. The one thing I never really got about Akame is, why is she the title character? Don't get me wrong, she's a great character, there's nothing wrong with her. But in terms of the story, she doesn't really do that much more than any of the other members of Night Raid. I mean, I guess her backstory has more focus, but she's not quite the center of the show. Really, calling it Tatsumi ga Kill would have made more sense. As for Tatsumi, he's a pretty good main character. He's the naive newcomer to the group who's not as skilled as a fighter, which, if written poorly, could have come off as being really annoying. Like, they could have him always screwing up and not knowing how anything works, resulting in the other characters berating him and leading to a lot of really forced, terrible comedy. But thankfully, they don't take that route. While he is a naive kid and has to learn to become stronger, the other characters are more than willing to teach him, and accept him as one of the group. Well, for the most part, there is a lot of friction between him and Mine at first, which does lead to some pretty obnoxious scenes. But that mostly stops after the first third of the show. The rest of the cast is also for the most part really likable. I will admit though that a lot of these characters do seem kind of tropey, which I know can put off some viewers. Like, you have the loud outgoing party girl, the bitchy tsundere who's always getting on the main character's case, the likably obnoxious womanizer, the stern commander. These are all pretty common character archetypes in anime. But for me, what I think makes them work really well is that they're a group. We spend the whole show getting to know them by seeing them interact with each other.
both while they're on missions or back at the base just training or eating meals. I love character casts that work like this, where you feel the group dynamic between them. Leone and Bulat are both fun, likable characters with a lot of upbeat scenes to level out the more serious moments. And even Mine, while she's annoying at first, gets some fantastic scenes toward the end of the show that, in my opinion, make up for everything. And every character is given a backstory that you can all understand and relate to. And you feel like you get to know them all better as the show progresses. It kinda reminds me of shows like Mare, where you start out liking it okay, but you find yourself loving it more and more the more you see it, because of how much you get to know the main characters. And when a character dies, it's really genuinely sad. That's another thing I should mention. This is one of the bloodiest anime I've seen to this date. Not just in terms of being violent and gory, though it is definitely that, but in terms of how many characters get killed off, both heroes and villains. And when a main character dies, you feel the loss because you've spent time getting to know each and every one of them. It's not like an Attack on Titan where they keep mowing down characters before you can even get to know them. Here you feel the full dramatic impact of every single death. But it never gets too depressing to the point where you want to stop watching it. The characters make it clear that even though it's terrible to lose someone they care about, this is what they signed up for, and they have to move on. One thing about the show that I didn't really like at first was the villains, who just seemed lazy to me. With these big, mean, over-the-top, ugly designs and having no motivation other than just to be evil dicks. Which, as most of you know, I hate. I think I actually facepalmed when one of the villains said this line.
Nothing like finishing off a long day of torture than knocking back a cold one.
Yeah, while you're at it, why not have him talk about how he eats puppies for dinner and steals teddy bears off of babies? But thankfully, this is another element that gets a lot better as the show progresses. About a third of the way into the story, we get introduced to a team called Jaeger, who are basically the Star Wolf of this show. The colorful team of villains that act as a rival to our main heroes. They all have memorable designs, personalities, and backstories, and it's fun to see them interact. I love it when shows have villains that are legitimately entertaining characters in the same way as the heroes. We get to learn what each of their motivations are for wanting to support the Empire, and it gives the fight scenes between them and the main characters a lot more depth because we've seen what they're like as people. The leader of this team is an Imperial general named Ezdeath, who is a great villain. Aside from being the most intimidating character in the show, she really gets interesting once they start developing her relationship with Tatsumi. Which I won't give away, but it's a route I've never really seen an anime villain take. And it leads to a lot of really tense, suspenseful moments, as well as adding a whole new layer of depth to her character. The action in the show is top-notch. The show mostly uses typical shonen-style action with the big, over-the-top, flashy moves and so on. Which I'm normally not the biggest fan of, but the pacing and the animation are just so good that I was able to get into it for the action itself and not just for the story behind it. The action scenes are all flashy, colorful, and you feel the excitement and suspense at just the right moments. I haven't had this much fun watching this style of over-the-top action since Ruby. Speaking of things about the show that are visually appealing, that's another thing I like about it. It is very colorful and nice to look at. I think this anime in particular especially deserves praise for this because there's such a strong precedent in really every visual entertainment medium that dark, violent stories have to be gray and miserable looking. Think about it, you got most M-rated video games, movies like Man of Steel, which try to be darker than their source material, and of course a whole host of anime. Telling a dark story does not mean the show has to literally be dark. It certainly doesn't distract from the drama in any way, and it gives us the chance to see a lot of nice, pretty visuals. If I had to have one complaint with the show, it'd probably be that the story, while not bad, is maybe a bit too basic and straightforward. It mainly just consists of Night Raid fighting off one bad guy after another until eventually the revolution happens and we can begin the climax. There isn't really much in the way of exciting twists and turns. It works okay, and I think the characters and the action are enough to keep most people interested. But if you're expecting a Code Geass or Death Note where you're totally invested in the complexities of the plot and constantly held in suspense as to where it's going to go, you're not going to get that here. It's not that kind of anime. But overall, I thought Akame ga Kill was a pretty kick-ass show. I really couldn't find much to dislike with it. Even some of the things I thought I wouldn't like about it at first, they end up fixing later. I love the characters, I love the action, and most of all, I love the fact that it's not afraid to incorporate real human drama. When the show was over, I wasn't left thinking about what a bunch of kick-ass action and cool moves I just saw. I was left thinking about the characters and all they had to go through. That's the part of the show that's going to stick with me for a long time. I can definitely give this one a solid recommendation for anyone who wants to watch a genuinely good action anime and doesn't mind a lot of gory violence along with it. This is ShadowACS, and I'll see you next time.